going to be able to get it together. We're not asking you to believe us. All we're asking you to do is, in the honesty of your own heart, check it out. See if the words that Jesus Christ spoke don't jive with history. You give it an honest evaluation. You give God an honest chance to bust into your heart, and I guarantee you, you'll not be disappointed.
Please don't trust us, don't believe a word we say. Look, investigate every single thing you think is fake. Evaluate and question anything you think sounds crazy. Don't delay, make some notes and start today. Ever you first pick up a Bible, look into what it claims. See for certain that you can find truth in Jesus' name. And dig deeper, check in with friends and study scriptures. Start to build on that foundation to see the bigger picture. Go to be a witness, fellow believer, brother, sister in Christ. With eyes wide open, focus with new sight. Know your life will not be perfect, in fact, far from it. But know that in the end, that through Him you'll reach the summit. Let go of the external and conquer every hurdle, and learn to live for Him, a decision that's eternal. It's not about religion or the church or doing works. It's more about admitting you yourself are falling short, believing in His plan, and know He understands, and see that He forgives you and He loves you where you stand. I know it sounds too easy, too simple of a deal, but those who have experienced His love know it's for real. A solid rock to stand on that no one can refute. The way out of the dark is in connection to the truth. Our fortress and our shelter, our refuge and redeemer, exceeds all that we need. He's our everlasting savior.
I pray, yes, if you're real, take this stuff from me, because I'm gonna die. And I was actually doing the drugs at that point. Over the coming weeks, I had an encounter with the love of God that is so real that it made me turn from wanting to hurt myself to wanting to love myself and my daughter, to just follow.
You've heard the story told about the man within the hole who tried to find his way out through every means you know. He tried through meditations to earn his own salvation and trust in holy men and practice all religions. He then began to think that maybe he did not exist and all of life was an illusion. But in the end, there he sits. So he fasted and he prayed and he did it every day and thought through his devotion and his works he'd find a way. He tried for many years to climb out of this hole and counted on himself and his own power and control. And after so much struggle and time spent in vain, he cried out to his maker to save him from the pain. Suddenly there came a man who seemed to understand. He was different from the others. He said he had a plan. He lowered down himself into the bottom of the hole and carried out the man from the darkness below. He said to trust in him. This man with such concern, such love and such compassion, asking nothing in return. The one who made the difference, the one who gave a hand, the one who made it happen. When you can't, you know we can. He pulled us from the hole through His mercy and His grace. We were sinners in the dark, and alone He took our place. His truth is all exclusive, but also all inclusive. The people that He saves proves His word to be conclusive.
I realize that in light of the truth of evidence,